The football juggling game is on. A strong cover-up is taking place in the match-fixing episode of the Goan football. Both the President Churchill Alema and the Secretary Jovith Lopez are on record that there is no evidence of match-fixing, although they have admitted that match-fixing takes place in Goa. Evidence, finding evidence is not a job of a politician, nor a job of a journalist, nor of a teacher. Collecting of evidence and placing it to appropriate authorities is a job of an expert. If a cobbler does the job of a doctor, then there is no need of a doctor. A cobbler's job, a cobbler knows. A doctor's job, a doctor knows. So politicians should do the work of what politicians should be doing, and a journalist should be doing a job of a journalist. So, coming to the point, evidence, it is for the authorities to find out the evidence and to fix who have been responsible for the match fixing in Goa. The match fixing is not just a small thing, it's a big racket taking place, having its links not just in Goa or India but overseas. Now, you have to trace the source of the money, from where the money comes from, and how this betting is taking place. Match fixing has been taking place, and everybody knows it. Match fixing is very disturbing news for Goan football. The very survival of Goan football is at stake. So many of the teams are very small teams coming from the villages, like the Garden Angel, Well Sampale, to name a Garden Angel team from Sawande. Had produced several players down the line, including Lactor Mascarenhas, who played as a 17-year-old for the club and went on to play for India, Sri Lanka and Dempo, some of the big clubs in India. Writing on Facebook, he says, teams like Garden Angel are like a platform for young players like him. He started as a 17-year-old in 1978, which was then called as the Senior Division League and not the Goa Professional League as it is called now. He writes, yes, these village teams are important because they give you a platform to perform and a talent without a platform means nothing. Though allegations of match manipulation are difficult to prove, the probe itself should not be taken lightly and has to be investigated by professionals. It appears that there was a complaint filed with the police somewhere in November by the Panjim-based team. Needless to say, this complaint should be pursued vigorously and has to be taken to its logical conclusion. We must not forget that the very survival of Goan football is at stake, he writes.
There was a police complaint somewhere in Panjim, registered by a Panjim-based club. And then also, why it took so much time for the GFA to set up an inquiry when a letter addressed to it by the All India Football Federation in March talked about the so-called match fixing. It is only when the match fixing caught prominent publicity in the newspapers that GFA woke up from his deep sleep.
It's not easy to find evidence. It's a painstaking job and only the experts can find it. Coming to evidence, the evidence will not come to you. You have to dig deep in the surface to find for vital clues. And you have the main culprits and the associates. So it's time to reach out to the associates, reach out to the main culprit and fix the responsibility so that this match fixing thing does not repeat it itself. Coming back to betting and match fixing, betting is taking place locally. The local players are small time players and they have not so much resources to fix matches in a big way. Big way is the sum of some 1 to 2 lakhs for the coaches, 60 to 70,000.